Of Jacob. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
While the crowd was pressing in on Jesus and listening to the word of God, he was standing by the lake of Gennesaret. He saw two boats there alongside the lake. The fishermen had disembarked and were washing their nets. Getting into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, he asked him to put out a short distance from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the crowds from the boat. After he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into deep water and lower your nets for a catch." Simon said in reply, "Master, we have worked hard all night and have caught nothing, but at your command I will lower the nets." When they had done this, they caught a great number of fish, and their nets were tearing. They signaled to their partners in the other boat to come to help them. They came and filled both boats, so that the boats were in danger of sinking. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at the knees of Jesus and said, "Depart from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." For astonishment at the catch of fish he had made seized him, and all those with him, and likewise James and John, the sons of Zebedee, who were partners of Simon. Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on you will be catching men." When they brought their boats to the shore, they left everything and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord. Those of us who run people organizations these days are trying to support each other. Whether your people organization is being the mayor, or being running a grocery store, or having to gather other people, these are times where one gets, you know, it's very challenging because you know you have to take risks in order for the organization to operate. But you know that the risks you take affect people's lives, you know, even in a potentially very harmful way, especially during this pandemic. And so you see a lot of ADIs out there about from administrators. And especially since you're nerve-wracked already trying to make decisions, and everybody comes through the door not only has an opinion, but has a very animated opinion. And they will yell at anybody at this point, to the point that, you know, people behind the deli counter are in tears. You know, they just are twitching when they go home. They're just trying to serve your coleslaw, now they're twitching. So it's a very challenging time these days because everything is amped up. Everyone is trying to do something, and everyone's nerves are on the final edge. And so trying to run the organization is very challenging. That's why it's good for us to read these readings and to be able to see this, to be able to see that everyone is a fool to some extent. And smart people know they're a fool. I don't know if that makes any sense, but smart people know they're a fool. They know that they have limits to their knowledge. They know that sometimes their thinking is off. They know that, okay, if I have a really good idea today, why didn't I have it the last 10 years? You know, other than the fact that I'm a fool, you know, smart people catch that. And so that's what even makes it more nerve-wracking, is to know, okay, I have like this huge responsibility, and yet I'm a fool. But that's the nature of the thing. St. Gregory the Great was so brilliant at saying this. He would say he was so much smarter and he was so much more holy when he was in the monastery. When he became pope and had to deal with the day in and day out problems of the church and had to deal with some of the scoundrels who tried taking advantage of the church, and he had to deal with all the in-between situations, he looked like a fool half the time, he figured, and he certainly didn't feel holy at all. And it's good for him to write that down, because he's one of the best popes of all time. And for him to admit that's kind of how it feels, you know, is good for us to hear and to be able to talk about. But that doesn't mean we can't do bold and interesting things. And that's where this gospel reading kind of brings us to life. You know, put out your nets. But we didn't catch anything. We feel like fools. We didn't catch anything. That's what we do for a living is fishing. And now I've got the master along with me out on the boat and I'm not catching any fish. I'm embarrassed. And he says, put out your nets. And then the nets get filled with fish. Try something. If you try something new, whatever you try, try it because you were told that in prayer. And have confidence. Have faith. This is going to work. It's so crazy. It's going to work. And to be able to listen to Christ in that capacity is something that means a lot to us. I was talking to some people lately, and we had all together too much coffee, so that's when all the big ideas started floating around. And but a really good idea stumbled out of our mouths. We know as a parish, we need to reach out to young people better, and we know we need to be doing a better job of evangelization. But how do we do all this right now? We should be starting an evangelization committee. And it just became very clear why we focus and narrow the work of that committee and say we're going to do evangelization online. So this is what this committee is going to focus on. What are we doing with our different media platforms? What media platforms should we be developing? And who's posting something daily? And what's the strategy for posting something daily? You see Walmart shaking in their boots because Amazon's running circles around them. Because Amazon's entirely online. And that's where everybody's going, especially younger generations. They don't even gather. Even before COVID, they didn't gather at the grocery store. They ordered their food online. It just shows up on their porch. And the younger generations who came from small families aren't used to a social environment, really. And they're more and more kind of heading in that direction of loving being at home. And if our big plan is to get them into church building, good luck, because they tend not to gather anywhere, not even bars or anywhere. They don't gather. They didn't gather before COVID. They're not going to gather during, and certainly won't gather after COVID. We have to put the nets out on the other side of the boat. We need to be able to do what we're doing currently, but keep building this thing up. Keep building up the Zoom. Keep building up these Facebook posts to continue to build up the new technologies of where young people are at and meet them, and dialogue with them, and engage with them, and help them to work through these same issues in their lives. Of how can they get in charge of their lives when so many times they feel like fools, and to help introduce them to Jesus Christ, who's helped us through that important juncture and can help them as well. Let us now offer our prayers to the Lord. Let us pray for our world, especially all those who build community on the internet, that they can be responsible in doing so, creating holy order there. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our church as we enter and discern our way into the future, that we will know how best to be able to enter that future and how we can let young people show us the way and older people show us the way. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all those who are sick. I especially want to, or injured, pray for Ava, who's part of the tri-parishes, who we pray for as she's paralyzed. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all those running schools these days, which is one of the more nerve-wracking tasks here, that they will be filled with spirit and joy and good dialogue, so that they can educate in a safe manner. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us pray for the special intention, which is for the I already did that as a special intention for the day. And let us pray for all of us who are grieving and for loved ones who died recently or for a while ago, members of our parish who were so vital and so loving to our community, and other family members as well, that they will be able to enjoy the heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
in our prayers, that we can cooperate with your love and your grace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
The divinity of this water and wine have come to share the divinity of Christ, who calls himself to share our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Lord, wash me of my iniquities and cleanse me from my sin. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise of the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O Lord, grant our supplication that this sacrifice we present in celebration of St. Gregory may be for our good, since through its offering you have loosed the offenses of the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Gregory you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teaching her by his words of preaching and keeping her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with all the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna on highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna on highest. O Lord, you are holy indeed, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they would become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this bread of life and this chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. We humbly pray that partaking of this body and blood of Christ will be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Jerome, our Bishop, and all the leaders of the church. Remember our brothers and sisters who've fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Remember
their kingdom all who have died. Have mercy on us all, that with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, and Joseph, her spouse, all the apostles and saints, such as Gregory, who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we with them merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, to praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
And now, here in the presence of Christ our Savior, we get to pray with him as he taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Grant us peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we be free from all sin and safe from all distress, as we await the joyful hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
now and forever. May this peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share a sign of peace with one another. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold the one who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are all of us who are called to this supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. O Lord, through Christ the teacher, instruct those you feed with Christ the living bread, that on the feast of the day of St. Gregory, they may nurture your truth and express it in works of charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We especially want to pray for all those who are working on vaccines and cures for COVID-19. I don't know if you read some of the health updates that come from our county, but our county's test positive rate is really one of the highest in Wisconsin right now. Just so you know that, we had 3 people from our county going to ventilators last week. And so for us to be able to be praying very fervently just for that purpose, and what a great reason for us to be gathered in prayer in person or online, is that we're praying over COVID and praying for it to go away. And so let us ask the intercession of Mary for that to happen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless us all. The Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ending. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks
be
to God.
We are sons of morning. We are daughters of day. The one who has loved us has brightened our way. The Lord of all kindness has called us to be a light for his people, to set their hearts free. Let us build the city of God. May our tears be turned into dancing.